Okay, where do we go from here? The good side of this, both cases. The Pennsylvania state says, whoops, wait a minute. No-fault divorce doesn't exist anymore. We find the same thing in Nebraska. What happens? And then the opposite end of that. What happens if those cases blow up and we don't get anywhere with them? Where do we go from there?
Well, that is a very good question. The reality, I think, is this. If you look back to the issue of abortion and Roe versus Wade that took place in 1973, we're almost 50 years into the fight, and it took a long time for people to start to see that abortion is killing children, that abortion is inhumane, that abortion, whether it's partial birth abortion or whatever, it violates every sense of morality. But it was a concerted effort by many people nationwide over the span of years. The issue of no-fault divorce has slipped under the radar. And part of the reason is because it's been done, while we're focusing on this, on Roe versus Wade, it's being done state by state. And people are being brainwashed to think that somehow no-fault divorce is the best interest of the children. You know, the children will be happier if their parents are happier. The children are resilient and divorce won't affect them, even though every bit of research contradicts that. But so there is a brainwash that's gone on for 50 years of no-fault divorce. And do we expect to win a battle overnight? We may win some. We may be able to make some strong cases. But the reality is this, you know, I mean, from my point, even though it should be immediately repealed, there's no doubt it's completely unconstitutional. But the reality is you also have to win hearts and minds. And what we're doing at this point is we're seeing people that are saying this is an issue. But nobody's ever talked about this. People that are very well versed in things that I've never thought about this. I had a senator the other day that I spoke with. He said, I've never considered this. And so, you know, what's going to be, we're going to have people within our legislature look at this, but we're going to have to, it's not going to happen overnight, you know, I don't think. But we are starting to make a stand. There's been many other people whose works have been out there. Is Civil Unit, Stephen Baskerville, William, Mike McManus, different people that have been trying to approach this issue from various perspectives. But, you know, we're trying to say, how can we mobilize not just people, but churches? Because churches have compromised on this issue. Churches should be teaching that, you know, Jesus said in Matthew 19, you know, what God has joined together, let no man take apart. And we've taken the so-called exception clause, and we've now made everything an exception.
Yeah.
And we're not even talking about the issue. It is a scandal that we are talking about the issue in the church.
We got 1 minute, Jeff.
We need to awaken the church as well.
We got 1 minute, Jeff and Matt.
Yeah, I think Jeff and I both have confidence that, I mean, we've gone through 50 years of no-fault divorce. There's not a single person that has not been affected by it. And there's nobody that's speaking out against it. And so what we've found is that just talking with people or sharing information online, I mean, people are gravitating to this issue. And so part of it is, like Jeff said, winning the hearts and minds, trying to educate people and bring awareness to this issue, because we feel like through that mobilization and getting people together to rally against no-fault divorce, we can make tremendous strides in the legislature or another aspects, and hopefully the culture as well, because it's not just the law, although that is important, because it doesn't provide currently protection in marriage, and so that's why you're seeing a lot of people my age and millennials that are not even getting married, because they see how frivolous and easy it is to get up. I mean, people don't take seriously what they're getting themselves into, and like Jeff said, the church has compromised tremendously, and it's a very unfortunate thing. Again, not to be judgmental for people's individual cases, because there's a lot that goes into that.
Matt and Jeff, we're going to have to go, guys.
You have to pull up the...
We're hitting a hard break. We'll have you back on. No, appreciate your time, appreciate your efforts, and Godspeed. We're going to hear from you again.
Thank you so much, BJ.
My pleasure. My pleasure. Thanks. BJ Edwards, along with Mr. Anderson. It's your last call.
Last Call with BJ Edwards. Real talk about real life.
Hey, we're back. Actually, we're here. Back on Saturday. BJ Edwards along with Mr. Anderson. Your last call, as usual, we talk about the family, family situations. We've had great discussions about no-fault divorce.
Wow.
You walk into court, and the judge acts as an administrator and destroys the family. Boom, gone.
They said something very profound. I never really thought about how one-sided the whole thing is.
Yeah, it's no fault.
I did think about it when I went through mine, but I didn't think about how to change it, or I did, you know, it's an important thing. It needs to be dealt with. It needs to be addressed.
Yes.